Once inside your WordPress dashboard, you'll see this LiteSpeed Cache button with all of the available options. There are a lot, and they're very confusing. So I'll just go over by each option in each tab, and I'll show you the best way to set it all up. So in the General tab, turn on Automatic Updates. I've never had any issues with LiteSpeed updating to the newest version automatically. Then click on Request a Domain Key and wait for a few seconds. Then refresh the page again, and you should have your domain key filled out automatically. By the way, I'll also show you how to set up a quick cloud CDN later in this video, and this domain key is needed for that as well. For guest mode, I highly recommend you activate this option because it significantly increases the loading speed for first-time visitors by serving them a default cached version of your site. However, if you are using a very cheap web hosting plan, you might not have enough resources to power this. So if performance actually goes down after setting up LiteSpeed, turn this off. And only activate guest optimization if your guest mode is on. It further increases loading time for first-time website visitors by serving them optimized images and code as well. Next, you'll need to type in your website IP address. Usually, it's quite easy to find. It's listed right below the input window. But if it's not, you can always check out cPanel or your hosting control panel to find out your public IP address and paste that instead. For notifications, I keep it off because I manage like 30 websites, but if you want to get news about features, etc., keep it on. Next, let us go into the cache options. Next to enable cache, choose on. Turn off cache logged in users and commenters. In my experience, these only use up resources with little to no benefit to your website. And for everything else on this page, you'll want to turn it on, as these options optimize your WordPress theme and plugins, which you most likely use. In the next tab, called TTL, you can leave it as default. This basically dictates how long your cached content is stored. The 1 year period is perfectly fine. Moving on to purge. Activate purge all on upgrades to clear the outdated WordPress cache whenever an update is available, saving you space. Now for serve stale, if you have a more powerful web hosting plan, turn this on. If you're using a cheap weak one, this will probably do more harm than good by consuming your available resources that you don't really have. For the rest of the options, the defaults are completely fine. The excludes tab is fine as a default value as well. Now for the ESI option, I recommend turning it off. When it's on, it basically separates specific parts of the web page into fragments, but LiteSpeed themselves say that it's easier for LiteSpeed to serve full pages, not pages split and then rearranged back to full ones. Once it's off, the other options in this section don't matter. Moving on to object cache, this is a very powerful option that will significantly speed up your site.
The unstoppable Exodia!
Impossible!
But sadly, not every web hosting provider offers this. From my testing, I found that Redis works better than Memcached, but to get these activated, you'll usually need to open up a support ticket or just ask them through the live chat support and then ask them to install it on your server because it is like separate software. Depending on your web hosting type, it might not even be possible to do this. For example, shared web hosting plans. But to know for sure, just contact the support and ask them to install Redis on your server. But if you want a hosting plan that actually supports all of these options and features, check out Scala Hosting and their managed VPS options. Not only is it a very powerful web hosting solution, in my opinion, it's the best web hosting service out there, period. Now, you'll also need to input the correct socket path and port for it to work. For host using localhost, might sometimes pick it up just fine, but you can always see if it's working or not by checking if it's enabled and the connection test is passed. If either one of these is not going through, just go bother the support team. They'll do it much faster than I could explain it here, and then scroll all the way to the bottom and make sure that persistent connection is on, cache WP admin is on, and store transients is off. Moving on to browser cache, turn it on. and make sure that the browser cache time to live is 31557600. That's 1 year, just in seconds. If you're running just a regular website, if you're doing e-commerce, reduce this to 1 month. So it's 43800 in seconds. Next up is the Advanced tab. Now, there's a very interesting option hidden in here. It's called the Instant Click. And what it does is when a visitor hovers over a button or a link, the web browser already starts loading the web page behind that button or link, even if they haven't clicked on the button yet. So when they do click it, it feels instant because it was already loaded in the background. I recommend enabling it because it does make the browsing experience for your users much better. But again, this does consume a lot of resources, so you might want to have a more powerful web hosting plan if you're going for this option. Just test it out before you enable it. If it sucks, disable it. The rest of the options in the Advanced tab can be left as is. Now let's move on to the CDN options. If you already use a CDN and don't want to switch, continue from this time. But if you don't know what a CDN is, it stands for a content delivery network. The way it works is that various service providers have servers all across the world. And once you add your site to that network, it distributes cached version of your site across these servers. So if your original web hosting server is located in America and you have a visitor from Europe, without a CDN, the content has quite a large physical travel time, reducing loading speed. But with a CDN, a copy of your web page might be right by the user and they get to view the page much faster just due to the multiple server locations. Most CDN providers offer a free and a paid plan based on usage. And there are plenty of different ones, but luckily for us, LiteSpeed creators have their own free-ish CDN called QuickCloud. And it's currently the number one fastest CDN in the world, according to speedvitals.com, so we'll be going with that. If you currently use Cloudflare free, I would ditch it for QuickCloud, because if you have a good web hosting provider like A2 Hosting or Scala Hosting, you get free premium credits of QuickCloud, essentially turning your free CDN into a premium one if you operate a small to medium site, just due to these extra credits that you get for free. To get started, navigate to the CDN tab, then choose QuickCloud CDN setup, scroll down a bit, and make sure to link your website with a new or existing QuickCloud free account. Once linked, you'll need to click on Run CDN Setup. Now, you'll get two name servers that you'll need to change. So navigate to your domain name provider. In my case, I use a domain from Hostinger, but a server from Scala Hosting. So I'll need to go to Hostinger, then domains and DNS settings to find what I need, even though I'm doing all of this on Scala Hosting. Now I'll just copy and paste these two values into the respective fields to get it linked together. And after this, it might take a while for the changes to take effect, because your website basically needs to tell every other website on the internet that, hey, my street address has changed, to visit me now, you'll need to use this new address instead. These changes usually take around 1 hour to take effect, but in my experience, it can be as long as 24 hours in some cases. But that doesn't mean we can't continue to work on our website during this time. So click on Review DNS Records to reach the Quick Cloud Control panel and click on My Domains. As you can see, my newest addition still has a yellow sign while it's automatically doing its thing, but once it's done, you'll see it like this with a green checkmark. Click on the website name and here you'll be able to track what type of optimizations Quick Cloud has done for you each month. As you can see, it's all free. Now, since I'm using Scala Hosting and they're an official partner of LiteSpeed, I get free premium credits each month. This allows me to use the standard plan with 84 servers across the globe instead of the free plan with only 6 servers. Providers like A2 Hosting, HemiCloud, Scala Hosting offer these free credits included within your plans, and they'll migrate your website to their servers for free as well. You can find discount links for all three providers in the description down below. Now, to get the most out of your QuickCloud CDN, you'll want to navigate to CDN config and scroll until you find three options. First one being enable quick backend. You want this on. Next up, it's block browser XML RPC. You want this on as well. And make sure to turn off restrict XML RPC requests. And finally, turn on hotlink protection. Next up, near your CDN settings, make sure that Quick Cloud is activated and CDN mapping is turned off. Now, your CDN might still be propagating, so your website might be unreachable for an hour while it gets sorted out. But don't worry, nothing is broken, just do nothing and it will start working. When it's back to being operational, we can continue our optimizations. Let's move into image optimizations and then image optimization settings. That's the cool part about Quick Cloud CDN. Unlike Cloudflare, it optimizes images for free. So select on for your auto request cron, auto pull cron, and optimize original images to keep backups. Make sure you remove original backups option is turned off. For optimize losslessly, you want that on to make sure your image quality doesn't degrade with the optimizations. And for EXIF XMP data, you can keep that off to reduce bloat on your website. As for everything else, you can leave that on for optimal performance. Now, here comes the big one, page optimization. In general, this is a do your own testing kind of thing, but I'll give you the options that tend to work for me best, no matter which site I'm working on. Of course, your experience might vary a little bit. In CSS settings, turn CSS Minify on, and for everything else, turn that off. Because keeping other settings on might cause a flash of unstyled content issues. It's basically a scenario where for a split second, users see different fonts and a broken website before it all turns good. Google really doesn't like this and users feel like they're navigating a broken mess if this happens, even if it makes your website a little bit faster. Finally, next to font display optimizations, you'll want to keep that on the default value. Moving on to JS settings, again, turn on JS Minify, but for everything else, keep it off. And make sure your JavaScript is loaded as delayed. In HTML settings, turn on the Minify option and DNS prefetch control, as well as remove WordPress emoji. For everything else in this tab, just keep it off. And then in the media settings, you'll want absolutely everything on. This will make sure that only those images that are visible to the user are loaded instead of every image on the page all at once, and that there are placeholders, making sure your website design doesn't break while this happens. In VPI, you'll also want everything on, and in media excludes, you can specify which images you want to always be loaded, not lazy loaded. So this usually includes your logo and the very first images displayed on your page. You can navigate to media and find a link that you can paste in here for all of these images that you just always want loaded. Now, in localization tab, I recommend you turn everything on. And I'll leave the most popular scripts that you should localize in the description down below, so just copy and paste it in from my comment. Yeah, and after this, your website is pretty much as optimized as it can be. Just make sure to don't have any duplicate caching plugins, like no image optimization plugins, no code minify plugins, because duplicates actually slow your website down instead of making it faster. And LiteSpeed Cache is the one-in-all solution. It does everything for you in one place. And if you want a more powerful web hosting solution that works perfectly with LiteSpeed Cache, check out the links in the description and I'll have as many discount codes for LiteSpeed specific hosts as I can find. Good luck creating your websites and I'll see you in the next video.